Hello, today I will show you how I created my play along video. Before I started my video, I went and found the images that I wanted, and I used this particular website to help me remove image backgrounds. It's very, very helpful. I created my program in PowerPoint. So let's go to PowerPoint and start a new presentation. Clean this up a little. Go to Insert. Go to Pictures. My picture is on my device. I have set up a folder with all of my images just to make it easier for myself. Here's my image. Okay. And now as I click on this image, I want to send this to the back. So I'll send it to the back. That way I can put my images on there and it won't move. It does sometimes move on me while I am creating. However, it's very, very easy for you to line it back up, but send it to the back. Now I'm ready to duplicate this slide. So I go over here and I right click and I find duplicate slide. I'll do that again. Okay, now we're ready to start on our presentation. Let's go to slide one. Let's go and insert a text box and create our title page. Okay, I'll name this one test. There we go. And now we're ready to add our audio. So to add our audio, I've already downloaded my music into an MP3 file. So I'm going to go to insert. Your audio button is over here. So go ahead and click that. It is located on my audio on my PC. We know the way. Here it is. I'm going to insert it. Okay. Now there's some helpful hints right here. If you go and you select play in background, okay, that's going to hide your image. That's going to play across the slides and it's going to loop until it stops. It will start automatically. Now, just my personal choice, I'm going to go to the animations and I'm going to open up my animation pane so that I can see what I'm creating here. I actually want to start the music myself. That way, when I go to screen record, I have control of that and I'm going to hit start on click. Okay, now let's do a quick test to make sure that this image is hidden and that my music starts on my click. I'll go to slideshow from beginning. Okay, success. Now we are ready to start to create our different patterns. So I'm going to go to slide two. I'm going to go to insert shapes. I'm going to choose my circle. Okay, get that the size that I want that for my presentation. I'm going to right click on my circle and I'm going to fill it white. Okay, that looks good. I'm going to copy and I'm going to paste these. I'm going to put 8 of these on here. My students seem to be responding really good at home with seeing the extra rhythm pattern or body percussion below the next one coming up, just to give them a prep. But you can design this however you want and just line it up. I know I'm going kind of quickly. Okay, there we go. After I line that up, now I'm ready to put my body percussion images in or my notation in. So I'm gonna go back to insert pictures. From the device, I am going to find my transparent pictures now that I have. So here's my 8th notes. I want to size that up the way I want it for the entire program. So all I have to do is copy and paste these. And the next slides. There we go. Let's put some quarter notes in. And I'll also put quarter rest. And I'll size those up in a minute. All right, here is my rest. Okay, so I did on my video go back to put in like a symbols chart for my students of what to say for these, and you can do that too. But for today, I'm just going to show you how to get started on this. Okay, so here are my three different images. And I'm actually going to, I have an intro in the song. And, you know, I took a lot of time just to make sure that these are equal and look good. So the one thing I love is to copy and paste these throughout the whole thing to keep them the same size and keep your presentation looking good. Okay, so there's my first rhythm that I have up there, and then I'll do my second pattern down here. Hey, there we go. And, you know, you just go through your process of what you already created to your music. All right, now let's say that the first line repeats for two times. So I'm going to insert a text box here. Okay, and I'll put in however many times that it repeats. Most of the time it's like four, but for this video, I'm just going to say two. You can size this up, move it wherever you want to, change the color. And then we can also just copy this. And we can also move it down here too, if we want to add that. Okay, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to start to animate this. And so I like to have my animation pane open. So I go to animations, animation pane. There we go. So that I can see this very clearly. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to go over here and I'm going to left click the image. Then I'm going to go over in the animations tab up here and I'm going to I'm going to click on add animation. And I like making that, I like having each of my patterns to pulse. So I'm going to use pulse and it makes that flash. Okay, now I go do the same procedure to the next image. And the next one, and then the next one, same thing. I just repeat this. After I get here, I do have a repeat, so I can actually go back here and add animation again. See where it's going to put up the five. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4. You can look at that over here. 5. Now I'm ready to put 6. That way you can check yourself. 7. Here is 8. There we go. So we've done that. Now I'm ready to go down here. Add animation for here. I can continue on. Add animation pulse. This one I actually added just two pulses on this one. And then the last one. Okay, so you can check yourself on the animation page over here on the right. And what I usually do is that I'll go to the slideshow and I'll go from current slide just to check it out. So what I'm going to do next is that I'm going to click, press down the space bar to make this animate each of the images. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then that's everything that I told it to do. Good job. Okay, I am going to do one more of these slides. Here's the best news about this one. So in a lot of popular music, this is going to repeat. So the best thing for this is that I can click on slide 2, right click, and duplicate that slide for later. And if you notice, it saves all the animations. Yay! That's outstanding. I love that part. And then the next part over here, I am going to show you that you do need to check on these. So I'm going to, let's make another duplication. All right, I'm going to delete this one. And then let's say that this particular one, I don't need all of these. So I'm going to get rid of those. I am going to keep these. But what I need to do is make sure that on slide number 3, okay, go to this image right here. Okay, come up over here and you're going to want to click there until you get this little arrow. And you're going to need to make sure that that says start after previous. Okay. You want this one to start with you so that you're in control, but every time you start a new slide, you need to make sure that the first one of these says start after previous so that you don't get any, or start after previous, sorry. Start after previous so that you can keep that continuous click. Okay, so let's give this a try. We have, this isn't exactly what I had on my video, but just to get you started. So let's go to the slideshow to see how it's going from beginning. Okay, remember I'm going to start it with my click and then I'm just going to do the different beats with my space bar. Slide on over to slide 2. One, two, three. And I'm just pressing the space bar right now. Okay, and so obviously, I have a different pattern on the other one, but just to give you an idea of how this works. Okay, so let's say that it's ready. You got it. Now, what do you do next? This is where I got confused, and it's actually not too hard at all. You need to pick out a screen recorder software. So there's lots out there like Loom. I actually use something called OBS. There's Screencastify, like I'm using it to make this video today. So after you go through this entire process and you check everything out and you are ready, then all you have to do is then come in to record it. And I'll go to OBS here. Okay, and I'm ready to screen record. And I'm going to start my recording. Okay, I'm going to go to my slideshow, beginning. Okay, and then I'm going to play it. Okay. And so this is going to screen record while I'm doing this live with just using the space bar to click this out. I'm just pressing my space bar here as it screen records. Okay. And then obviously you want to come in here and stop your recording. It makes a video for you. Helpful hints here. Make sure that you wear headphones so that you that helps you with precision of creating your rhythm patterns, your body percussion with the music. So after that makes the video there, then some software already have editing abilities in there. I actually went to Adobe Premiere, and I downloaded my video here that I made, and I just trimmed it up. I used my razor over here to get rid of the extra beginning and a little bit extra on the end, and then I went into video transitions and I just started something where it just started my, I chose Iris box on this one just to start it a little bit differently, as you can see right there. And then I'd put a film dissolve at the end. After I did that, then I went to file and then I exported this out into YouTube. So I made sure that my music was okay in here too. I can mix my music if I need it louder. So Adobe is helpful in that way. Okay, well, that's how I created my two. I'm sure there are many different ways. I hope this was helpful and I wish everyone good luck. So thank you very much.